It's 1 year since I bought the laser welder. This, I'm convinced, is the future. It might even put some people out of business. So about a year ago, I bought this welder from China. I bought it off Amazon because I was worried that, not get scammed. But I've had this for about a year. You know, you see all the videos on TikTok and YouTube about these two pieces of plate together and just quickly welding. If you have two pieces butted together or two pieces top of each other, this thing is, I could teach somebody how to use this in 30 minutes. But we all know that the majority of welding is never really just butt welding or lap welding. And that's where this has some learning curves. I really think if you're a skilled MIG welder, this is going to be really easy to pick up because some of the techniques that you use to fill gaps and stuff are the same as MIG welding, like a J to fill gaps. And I'll fill gaps probably as big as a quarter inch with this. But once you start kind of molding your technique to this technology has so much more capability than any sort of other welding process has. As you see, I do quite a bit of stainless steel welding, and I'm able to do welding on stainless steel that would usually require a TIG process at least 5 times faster with higher quality. And a lot of this stainless steel stuff that I do is not high pressure. It's mostly done for corrosive environments. Back purging is not required. A lot of welding for a fraction of the cost if you compared it to somebody that is going to, you know, croak these type of systems out with a TIG process. Now, the differences between this and, like, say, a TIG or a MIG that I've noticed, protective lens that's in here, the actual gases that you're using for your shield gas comes through this part of the body and then comes out of the tip. But a lot of times your flow weights for gas is determined on how to keep this lens clean and not your actual weld puddle. And the interesting thing with that is because of the laser light that's heating up the actual metal and pulling it, I don't see, you know, with TIG, you have to be careful of or MIG, cooling the weld pedal too quickly, get the porosity. With this, It does not affect the weld pool as much as any other process. And so usually your flow that you're usually choosing is dependent on the wattage and trying to keep this lens clean. And so you're probably using 1.5 times more flow than like a TIG process or a MIG process. And for like stainless steel, you're using nitrogen. And it has to be a very pure nitrogen because you don't want any sort of contaminants in between the laser light and the protective glass, or it literally just put a little bit of an imperfection on that glass. The laser beam will be deflected, hit the body, and the body will detect it and then shut down. This needs a protective glass that's very clean. But other than that, the wire, you don't use as much wire as like a MIG process. MIG process, the wire is being used to, one, create the arc, create the heat, and then deposit metal. This is a straight depositing metal. So you don't use as much wire at all. Like, I'm still on one roll, and I would have probably gone through 3 or 4 rolls by this time through a MIG process. Consumables of this is, literally, these are still some of the original consumables I've had, and the only thing I've had to replace quite a bit is the protective lens. And those range from $6 to $7. And usually I've noticed that lighter wattages, like 500 watt protective lenses, last a really long time. Up to like the 1200, up to 2000 watts, what this machine is built for, you have to flow a lot of gas, a lot more gas than you would typically flow to protect that lens, or you're gonna be burning through consumables a lot. And also, I've noticed that when I line up the laser, some of the instructions say put a piece of tape on this and try to line it up center. What I've learned is you actually want to try to line up the laser to be center of your wire down a little bit, because you don't have a direct path usually at that point, as much of a direct path to the lens. And if this is centered and you go straight onto a material, that laser beam has a potential of reflecting back and then burning up the protective lens also. So really from a consumable side of things, that's the only thing that you have to, you know, worry about. From a usability perspective, this is clunky. You have to get really used to kind of wielding this around. You know, this probably weighs 3 pounds, and really it can only weld in this direction. I've been able to weld side to side, but really it's happy welding from this direction down. And so you have to get used to, you know, approaching your welds in that sort of, you know, that sort of mindset. You know, I've had to also kind of hold up the cable with weight helpers and such to try to get into tight corners. So, you know, this could definitely be improved on, you know, ergonomically. You know, I don't know how you would improve on it, but if there's work to be done in a system like this, it's definitely in the handheld application. But once you get used to it, you know, I'm even thought about selling my TIG machine. This thing is the future. And the reason it's the future, the amount of heat that you can put into a certain location, a whole lot easier with this machine than a TIG. TIG, you're worried about where that arc's going. This, it's your point and shoot. And even if you're not feeding it with wire, fit up is really good. I'm just using the laser to melt the material together. And when you can do that and you don't have to rely on the wire, you can get into really tight spots with this and really clean welds. This thing, you know, the fatigue level, other than the weight of the gun, is a whole lot less than TIG. One, there's less heat. I'm literally wearing a t-shirt and shorts welding with this, where with the TIG machine, you have to be pretty, in any sort of welding, arc welding process, you have to be, you know, suited up pretty well. Now, the safety comes in the laser light. If you're not paying attention and you push the trigger, and you know, this comes with a safety where it's supposed to have this touching the metal before it turns on, and highly recommend using that as long as you can. But really, like with anything else, you know, you realize how you can, you know, get rid of that and be able to kind of open up where this doesn't have to be touching something and you can weld material with it. But coming with that, it's a safety. You're putting a high energy beam out there that if you're not paying attention, you know, you'll look down there and your work boot has a burn mark 3 feet away from this thing. Safety is a different animal with this, in that treat it like a gun. You know, pull the trigger and it's gonna shoot a beam, high energy, and it can do a lot of damage within, I'd say, 5 feet easily, if not farther away. Ease of use of this thing is incredible. You know, welders out of there, if they don't adapt to something like this, they're going to be left behind, because the throughput you can have with this, and again, the quality of welds, you don't have to try as hard to get a great weld with this as if you're a professional welder. And it's going to bring up a lot of novice welders into work that they might have never touched before because they haven't had the practice. And then actually with people that do have a lot of qualifications, something like this, you know, it's going to increase your throughput. It's going to be less fatiguing. I've noticed that I can weld a lot more and not be as tired as if I was going to do it with any other sort of process, MIG, TIG, things of that nature. You know, this thing is the future. And I know some people have posted up videos, you know, complaining about how it's not doing what it says it's supposed to do. Well, the advertisements are of, like I said before, butt welds, lap welds, you know, very quick. And it does that just as it's advertised. But it does take some getting used to and some practice to use it in a normal welding process. And I think if you put the effort in that, you're not gonna go back. My MIG welders, literally, I think I've turned it on one time in this last year. And that's usually like, I don't really want to weld with this that's got a lot of rust or something of that nature. A lot of off gases, like a farm, you know, farmer repair, where you're not really gonna, you know, maybe clean the material as good as you should. Where the MIG, you could just kind of blow through it, get a weld to hold two pieces of metal together. You're not gonna use this. It wants clean metal. The other two functions, you know, it's a 4-in-1 welder, does this laser clean, which I'll put some video up here. And the laser clean is awesome too. Like, I haven't really found a great use for it because I don't really deal with a lot of rusty metal or painted metal. But I had an old car panel over there that I took this to, and it just strips the paint right off. I'm interested to see what I can do with that later. But you got to change the lens out, put a different tip on it. So it takes a little effort to get to that. And the third function is the weld clean, which is basically a miniature version of the paint removal process where you just change this tip out, don't have to change the lens out. And you can clean up welds where you're taking some of that tarnish off of like a stainless steel weld. What I've used that for is if I have to re-weld something that's been in service for a while, I could put that laser clean in it. And instead of having to grind that weld off, I can use that laser clean to clean off that weld and then just go right on top of it. And no grinding, you know, and that comes in handy when it's a very tight spot where you really probably couldn't get a grinder into it. So I've used that with some success. And the last thing I want to talk about is the laser cutting capability of this. Now, look down in my description, and I have the start of a video of two or three part series of where I basically take this machine, and it has a laser nozzle that you put on this, and then you put it on a CNC table. And now my small shop, I have, where before I had CNC plasma cutting capabilities, now I have laser cutting capabilities. Now I've cut up to half inch with this, and it's the detail you can get off of it is the cuts are much cleaner and the precision is much, it's higher than the plasma could ever get. And that's really exciting to me because like my fitments are better. My sheet metal parts are tighter. I can do very detailed work where the plasma could never even get to that point. So click the link in the description for those videos, and I'll have one at the end of the video. I bought this a year ago, and I'm not looking back. This is the future. Yeah, if you have a fab shop, you need to look into getting one of these.